Hallelujah. Please, when it's live, let me know. Already? Okay. We bless God. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We want to say good evening to every one of us. The Lord Almighty God bless you. The Lord be with you in the mighty name of Jesus. On behalf of, I can't say on behalf of Babatunde. Babatunde, daddy has gone. So on behalf of the entire family, the Olubajo's family, Olubajo, yeah, Bajo, thank you, ma. On behalf of the Olubajo's family, both home and abroad, we want to say a very big welcome to every one of you that has come to grace this occasion. A few weeks ago, daddy went to be with the Lord. He passed to glory. And today is the service of song of the homegoing. We appreciate God for the life that daddy has lived. And he lived his life gloriously. Burial, service of song, whichever thing we do after somebody has died, he has gone. Everything that we're doing is for both those of us that are seeing on the land of the living. For us to take stock, it's a time of appraisal, it's a time of reckoning, a time to examine ourselves. So we want to say good evening once again, and the Lord bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. In the land of the UK, on behalf of our pastor and Pastor Mr. Otori, I want to say in the land of Gloucester, say welcome to you as you come to greet this occasion. And the entire family in the land of the UK, want to say thank you. The Lord bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. We want to say sorry that we are starting a bit late. It's a bit late. It's just 45 minutes late, so it's a bit late. Hallelujah. So forgive us. Hallelujah. So forgive us. The Lord bless you. We are going straight into it. And we promise you, we won't take too much time. Praise the Lord. As we go straight to the program, I will call on one of our mommy from Luton, Pastor Mrs. Dada, as she lead us in opening prayer. Let's put our hand together for Jesus. God bless you. Usher, microphone, please. God bless you. That is what COVID has caused. So we just have to manage it. God bless you. Until you, ma.
We want to bless the name of the Lord this evening. Want to thank God for making today possible. And I'm not preaching, we have preachers. But I just want to encourage us as we go to pray that the Bible encourages us to rejoice always. And the Bible encourages us that we should give thanks in all circumstances. We are not here to mourn. We are here to thank God for a life well lived. We thank God that we did not go before Baba. So let us pray. Our Father, we are grateful this evening. Father, we want to commit tonight's meeting into your hand. We ask for your presence, even to go into this evening program with us. We ask, O Lord, that let everything we do here today be to your glory in the name of Jesus. We ask, O Lord, for each and every one of us that are here and for people that will yet join us. We ask, O Lord, that none of us will leave this place the same, O Lord. We ask you will speak to us. We ask everything will work well. We pray for people that are on their way, that you bring them here safely in the name of Jesus. We take authority over anything because we do not take your grace for granted. Whatever the enemy may want to use, even not to cause our joy to be full tonight, we take authority over such. We ask, O Lord, we declare today's meeting open in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And Spirit of the living God, we ask that you would take your place. You do that which the Father has asked you to do here today, so that at the end, once again, only your name will be glorified. Blessed be your name, Lord. In Jesus' name we have prayed.
Shall we all please stand as we take our first hymn?
Bless the Lord. Like never before. worship his holy name.
Shall we please sit?
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We are number 3 on the agenda. By the grace of God, I remain your humble host tonight. And my choir leader will be coordinating. Hallelujah. The welcoming will be between me and the celebrant. The one I could not do, she will finish it off for me. Hallelujah. Or he will finish it off for me. Amen. I want to say a very big welcome to everybody. Once again, you are blessed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I want to say a very big thank you to Pastor and Pastor Mrs. Dada for making it way down from Luton. I know it's not really easy. M1. It's a wonderful motorway. Hallelujah. You are welcome. Mommy and Daddy, you are welcome. Let's appreciate them, please. Let's appreciate them. The Lord honor you in the mighty name of Jesus. My humble pastor from Ireland. Amen. We have been together since yesterday. PSG. Did I get it right? Hallelujah. Pastor Gbadebo from Ireland. We thank you so much, sir. The Lord bless you in the name of Jesus. They are all sons of the soil. I want to say a very big welcome to another father of the soil. Hallelujah. The territory man. Praise the Lord. I used to call him Maria Father. He said, I should not call him Maria Father. Our son of pastor from Bristol. Let's put our hand together for Jesus. As we welcome Pastor Ladiko. You are welcome back to your home in the name of Jesus. And our brother from Bristol as well, we thank you so much. I want to say a very big welcome to Pastor and Pastor Mrs. Oyada from Overcomer's House, Gloucester in Parry Road. You are welcome, sir. God bless you. God bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. I want to say a very big welcome to my humble brother and sister at the back. Sorry, sir, I may not know your name now. But Pastor Dada will help me out at a point. Hallelujah. For everybody that I don't know you by name, the Lord knows you. He has written your name in his palm. He knows you very well. You are the apple eyes of God, and you are blessed in the name of Jesus. All my in-house ministers, you are welcome. The Lord bless you. The Lord will honor you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And I want to say also a very big welcome to my wife. She's everywhere. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's appreciate her, please. God bless you. Hallelujah. I will hand over at this point to my choir leader as he take us through the next program on the agenda, item number 4. God bless you. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. As we continue with the celebration of life of Baba Ade Olubajo, I would want us to please rise onto our feet as we take hymns 3 and 4.
Have in Jesus all our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. Oh, cross we do not carry. Everything to God in prayer. Have we trials and temptations? Is there trouble anywhere? We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Can we find a friend so faithful, who will all our sorrows share? Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Precious Savior, still our refuge. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Do your friends despise, forsake you? Take it to the Lord in prayer. In his hand he'll always shield us. You will find a solace there.
Amen. Amazing grace. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound, the saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did the grace appear, the heart of first believed. Through many dangers, toils and snares, I have already come. His grace has brought me safe thus far,
and grace will lead me home. The Lord has promised good to me, it's worth my hope secure. Shield and portion be as long as life endures. Yes, when this flesh and heart shall fail, and mortal life shall cease, I shall possess within the veil a life of joy and peace.
The last verse.
The heart shall soon dissolve like snow. The sun forbear to shine. But God who called me below will be forever mine.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Please don't let us forget, it's a solemn service of song. Don't let us be tired. Actually, we come here to sing and we say the service of song. So please, get ready to sing solemnly to the glory of God as Daddy is going to the Father. We'll be taking our first Bible reading. Can I have my pamphlet, please, ma? That one, my pamphlet. No, pamphlet, the one with you. Thank you, ma. We'll be having our first Bible reading. After that, we're going to hymn 5 and 6. After that, we're going to another Bible reading, second one. Then we forget to tribute. Please, ma, when we get to tribute, I want to beg you. Baba has gone. Praise the Lord. I know you are bound to be emotional, yeah, because nobody wants their loved one to go. He has gone. He has gone to rest. He has left the life of a generator everywhere, all over there. I better pass my neighbor. Nothing like that any longer. He has gone to rest. Praise the Lord. The Lord will bless you. You are beautiful. I don't want any tear to disturb that beauty, please. Let it remain like that. One of my funny daughter was asking me last week. The lady is so funny. He said, Pastor, as you are preparing for the service of song, he said, do you know if Phyllis mom has seen your mom? Honestly, he said, as Brad, my mommy died in December. Brad Phillips' mom died in March. He said, by now they must have seen themselves. I look at this lady. I said, I'm still crying inside. You are asking me this question. So Baba has gone. He has gone to rest. Please, I beg you. The Lord will be with you. Holy Spirit will comfort you in the mighty name of Jesus. I will call on Sister Dotun as we lead us in the first Bible reading. God bless you, ma'am.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Dotun Alunge, and I'll be taking the first Bible reading from the book of John, chapter 14, verses 1 to 3. I'm reading from the New King James Version. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe in also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also. May the Lord bless the reading of his word.
Shall we all rise to do hymns 5 and 6? Lord, my God.
Oh, Lord, my God, when I'm in awesome wonder, consider all the worlds thy hand hath made. I see thy power throughout the universe display. Then sings my soul, then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee.
How great,
how great thou art.
When through the woods,
when through the woods and forest glades I wander, and hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees. When I look down from lofty mountain grandeur and hear the brook and feel the gentle breeze,
then sings my soul,
then sings my soul, my Savior God.
to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art, how great thou art, then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think, that God his Son not sparing sent him to die, I scarce can take it in. That on the cross my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul,
then sings my soul,
my Savior God to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art,
then sings my soul,
my Savior God to thee. How great thou art, oh great thou art,
when Christ shall come,
when Christ shall come with shout of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art.
Then sings my soul,
then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee.
How great thou art,
how great thou art. How great thou art, then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee.
How great thou art,
how great thou art,
how great. Six, great is thy faithfulness.
Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not, thy compassions they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever will be. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand has provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Summer and winter and springtime and harvest, sun, moon and stars in their courses above, join with all nature in manifold to thy great faithfulness, mercy and love. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies are seen. All I have needed, thy hand had provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me.
Pardon for sin.
Hallelujah.
Pardon for sin and for peace that endureth. Thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide. Strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings all mine with 10,000 beside. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies are seen. And all I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me.
Please we'll be taking the second Bible reading. But before that, a very brief housekeeping. Please, for all our invitees, the gents and the ladies, when you go out, is to the left, please. The Lord bless you in Jesus' name. This is the exit, and this is the entry. I think you came in through the entry. Please, when you will be going out, this is the exit. It's a one-way traffic. Praise the Lord. So you come in through this side, and you go out through the other side. As a church, we know what is going on all over the world about this COVID-19. And there's guidance. We thank God that the church is not locked down. The Lord still give us grace to come together. As a church, we are 100% compliance with the government regulation. We don't break a single law, and I believe every one of us, we are not lawbreakers. So for the program of today, we will still be compliance, 100%. So please, and we know what is going on now is a rule of six. Please, at every point in time, don't congregate together, don't cluster together more than six at any point in time. Please, we beg you. In the church, outside the church, please, when you form a bubble, don't let your bubble be more than six at every point in time. That's number one. Number two, for us to be, we know we are Africans and we love a communal life. In fact, before we know, it has gone. We know that one, but we need to please and discipline ourselves very well in time of that. So at the end of the service, please, that's going to build a protocol, that's going to be an orderliness. After the service, we will all sit down. We are not going to go out in mass. We go out line by line when the time comes. Praise the Lord. We won't release everybody at the same time. We all sit down after the service. The celebrant, we have time to socialize with you, to say thank you. After she has said thank you on the pulpit, she also have time to go around after the service for about 5 minutes to say thank you to every one of you. I know she will love that. I will love that. So we won't just ask you to just go out after the service like that. Please, we want to beg everybody after the service, remain seated. Please, we are situated at the city center of Gloucester, and police is parading left and right to make sure everybody's compliant. So remain seated after the service. The celebrant, we have time to go around. I don't think she will want to shake hand. Hallelujah. But she will have time to greet you, to say hello to you, to say thank you for coming. After she has said that, we will have the privilege to now file out to go home, to go to our various destination. Please, we will file out line by line. When it's not yet your turn, please don't stand up. Praise the Lord. That is what COVID has brought. Treating us like primary one children, praise as they do in kindergarten. We just have to do that, and the Lord will bless us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So please let us be 100% compliant. And when you go out, we want to beg you, don't congregate outside. Don't form cluster. Can you just let us go straight to our car and drive back to our destination? The Lord Almighty God will grant us journey mercy in the mighty name of Jesus. I will call on Sister Ronke as she leads us in the second Bible reading. God bless you. God bless you, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Praise the Lord. My name is Olu Ronke, and I'll be taking the second Bible reading from 1 Thessalonians 4:13-18. From verse 13. But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye may sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and he rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. Verse 15. For this we say unto him by the word of the Lord,
that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. We which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds, to which the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Verse 18. Wherefore comfort one another with these words. This is the word of the Lord.
Shall we appreciate God, please? Let's appreciate God. God bless you. Let's appreciate him. Hallelujah. We are going to number 8 on the program, which is the tribute. We'll be taking tribute from the daughter of Baba. Hallelujah. And we'll be taking tribute from the son of Baba as well. Praise the Lord. Yinka Odulami and Odunlami and Ayo Olubajo get ready as well to give tribute. We are sorry we won't be able to accommodate everybody. So please, if you really want to give tribute and there's no time, please just forgive us and the Lord bless us in the name of Jesus. So let's Pastor Wotori get ready. Yinka Odunlami and Ayo Olubajo get ready. Hallelujah. The Lord bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. As I said, please, Baba has gone to rest. Praise the Lord. If I say don't cry, it's a lie. There's no way. During my own time, I cried. So it's part of it. If you have not cried for the past few weeks now, I will say something is wrong. Praise the Lord. But we should not mourn like an unbeliever. Praise God. So Holy Spirit will comfort you in the name of Jesus. The vacuum that Baba has left behind, the Lord will fill the vacuum for you. The gap that has been created, the Lord will bridge the gap in the name of Jesus Christ. So as we go to that, I want to use this medium to say to send our condolence also to Feyi Shola Olubajo, is the junior sister to Pastor Msewo Tori. She's in Nigeria. She's also the daughter of Baba. As you are listening to us and you are watching us live, we say a very big condolence to you. And the Holy Spirit will comfort you in the mighty name of Jesus. And also to the family of Baba, Taiwo Olubajo, Muyiwa Olubajo, Abayomi Odusanya, and Ayo Olubajo. We are praying for you. The Lord will be with you in the mighty name of Jesus. As Yoruba will say, Eroni Banyo, in the name of Jesus. Please, for those that don't understand my local language, please just bear with me. When you speak in tongues, you might not be able to understand. Praise the Lord. So if I speak any other language than English, I'm speaking in tongues. Hallelujah. So as Yoruba, we pray a prayer for all the family of Baba of the deceased. Oluwa to leru abayin gbe o, in the name of Jesus. Jesu to leru na loloshuka abayin gbe ero ni bayin o, in the mighty name of Jesus. And it is well with you. I want to call on the daughter of the deceased of Baba. Please, can we have the microphone as she come up for her tribute? Please, let us make it short. There's no amount of time you can take that can bring Baba back. She has gone to rest. So he has gone to rest. So please, make it brief, ma. And as I said, I don't want to see you cry. Please. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I want to appreciate, first of all, everybody here. You are so important to me. And I thank you for taking out your time to come to my father's service of song. I do not take it for granted at all. Thank you so much for your time, you know, for traveling all the way from London, different places. I just appreciate you. God bless you. Baba me. I don't even know where to start from. I just want to thank God for the life of my father. Babatunde Abiodun Olubajo. When I was growing up, he used to take us to Ijebu for Christmas. We don't miss Christmas for anything. And there's a particular Baba there. Each time he sees me, he will say to me, Omo Nina Lowo, the daughter of Nina Lowo. The Baba happened to be my father's, like a teacher. My father used to be a teacher a long time ago. He used to be a teacher. And each time he sees me, he taught my dad. He will say to me, "Oh, money no low." And I one day I asked him, "What do you mean by it? Oh, money no low?" He said, "That is what I used to call your dad." And you know, Baba me, like I used to say, he's so dear to me. Everybody that knows me, that's very close, will know that I talk so much about my dad. He's a man that I so much cherish, a man that has sacrificed a lot for me. I used to remember when I was very, very young, I used to be very sick. They used to take me to different places. Even he would travel with me to different places. But, you know, that's the way they think they can, you know, protect me. He himself, I'm always going with him to different places, and you know, he would look after me. And you know, he's a man of few words. He's a man of very, very few words. He's a very lovely man that, you know, when I was young, all his families, we have different, he has different clubs and family meeting. I grew up to know that we're always having meeting upon meeting in our houses. He's always up and doing in the family with his friends. He has different kind of clubs in Jebu, in Lagos. You know, we're always having one thing or the other in our house. There's no one month that we don't have one thing to do and we are always cooking. I grew up to know that. He's a man that loves people. He carries people along, his family, his friends, is always up and doing there. Even when he gave his life to Christ, it was too much. He was up and doing in the church. He's a very generous man. He doesn't mind to give all he had just to help. He doesn't hide things at all. He wants to, I know him for that. His family, if he goes this place, he will make sure that his family member that are close to him must know where he's going. You know, things of information that can benefit them. I've known him to be that. My father, he loves God so much. Up to his death, he feared the Lord. He's a man that feared the Lord. Something happened sometimes ago. My father, when he was 70 years old, the church that he attended Redeemed Church of God in Surulere. His house is very far. It's not even near to where he lives. But he would make sure by 6 o'clock he's out of the house. He would not eat breakfast. And on this, in his church, people call him Baba Mileko, Baba Mileko. I'll be wondering, which one is Baba Mileko they're always calling you? Because I sometimes will see him in the house. He will have different purses, you know, bags for different money. And he will label each body's, everyone's money there. I will see their name. And I will say to him, who owns all this money? He will say, people in the church. They will put money in his hand. And, you know, he would be accounting for every kobo. He said he would rather go hungry than, you know, make a mess of people's money. And they would come to him, and he would, you know, they would keep money in his hand. But I've seen it, not that he told me. I saw it on different occasions that he would keep money in his hand. And he kept money in his hand, and he would be true to what they gave to him. Baba me, you know, this man is a very gentle man. I've never seen my father argue with anybody. I've never seen. My mom is a very strong person. But you can still condole her, as in she's a very quiet person with a very outspoken person. My mom, I've never seen them quarrel and they will go to anybody. I've never seen. Since I have been, I've never seen. Very quiet man. I could remember when he was 70 years, I didn't finish that. 70 years old, and I asked him, what do you want me to do? What do you want us to do for you? He said he doesn't want anything for his birthday. I was saying, what do you want? He said, nothing. But you know what? On that day of his birthday, I was being called up. He told me that in their church, they told him that they are planning something for him. I said, planning what for you? To do a birthday for you. I said, in my lifetime. And somebody else will do birthday for my dad, and I will not be there. Instantly, I just quickly called different people, my friends, to just quickly organize something that same day. Because he told me he doesn't want anything. And to his surprise, that day they told him that, Baba, we are doing something for you in the church. I was like, I just quickly, that morning, I rushed different places. You do this for me, do that for me, get cake, get drinks, get that. And I came up there, they were all surprised that same day. To tell you that the way they hold him in high esteem in the church. Even I have known a particular one or two, three girls, young girls, who just graduated. Since they graduated, every blessed month, they will say, Baba, this is money for you. All this money for your upkeep every month. He's not a family to them. Because of the child, those girls' parents. And I don't know what happened. I don't just know that every month they must just say, Baba, we want to appreciate you every month. I don't even know the girl from Adam, those children. And they will give Baba every month money. And say, Baba, thank you. And they will put money in his hand. Baba me, like I used to call him. I call him Baba. We are not much in his hand. And sometimes I will say to myself, maybe this man has some, maybe has a child outside. That this man has a child outside. We are just two girls. And sometimes I will look and say, maybe this man has a son somewhere. But up to his death, I've never seen anybody came up and said, oh, this is their father. It's so surprising to me that just the two of us, I love my dad. When he was about to die, he's been telling me that he's going. I said, going where?
He said, he's going, I've come to pick him. And I said, go anywhere, you're not going anywhere. You are coming to see me in England. And he said, well, yes, he's coming. And one particular day, my sister had to call me and said, I don't know what is wrong with daddy. He calls him daddy. I call him Baba. And said, he said he's going, daddy, go and call the pastor. The pastor come and pray for him. And I said, why are we going? He said, he's going. They should come and pray for him now. He did not rest until my sister went to go and call the pastor. And the pastor prayed for him. And he now, you know, for a while he was quiet. And since that time, my father's just, he doesn't really engage me much. He hardly even called me. Sometimes I just call him and just to psych him up and see maybe maybe his senses are still there. He's still very strong. You know what he's saying? And I'll say, but do you know me? He said, And he will laugh and laugh and laugh. And I said, what do you think I do? How can we not know you? He will laugh. And I said, I'm just asking. And I'll say, Oluba, do you know me? Babatunde, do you still know me? He said, yes, he knows me. And I'll just try and, end the conversation. I will cry sometimes. And the fear that I have so much, for I've dreaded so much in my heart, is the day that he would just pass on. Each time my sister called me, I miss many calls from my sister. I will be afraid that, what is wrong? Why are you calling me? Why are you calling me like this? What is wrong? What is wrong? What is wrong? We said, nothing is wrong. I said, why are you calling me? What's the matter? I know. Time. The third time is gone, Baba. To talk about you, Baba Tunde. I know you have to go. But you mean so much to my heart, you know that. I don't play with you, you know. I can sacrifice anything. Anything for my dad. My mom knows. I said, whatever I cannot get from you, your dad will get it from you.
That's okay. God bless you, man. It's okay. It's okay. That's okay. Hallelujah. Let's appreciate God. Let's appreciate God. Baba was 86. If he was 90, we will still cry. There's nothing we can do. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Please come forward, sir. Please, Pastor, just be less emotional. Just be less emotional. Baba has gone to rest.
Praise the Lord. Because of our time, I'll just read and maybe paraphrase. Tribute to Pa Babatunde Abiodun Olubajo. I've known Pa Olubajo for more than 23 years. I entered the Olubajo family as a son-in-law. But when Baba will open his door to me, he opened his door to his son. He let me into his house as a son. And from that day henceforth, he has treated me as a son. From the very first encounter. Baba loves his children so dearly. And you can know it if you have a short interaction with him. Pa Olubajo was like a father figure to me, but his manner of humility was great. Throughout the 23 years plus that I've known Baba, and he has like taken me as an adopted son, he never for once addressed me as Shegun. Not one time. It was either Pastor Shegun or Pastor Owo Tori. What a level of humility. He was a man of prayer. There was even a time that the sister called from Nigeria and said to the senior sister, "Come and hear your father." And he put it in speaker. And Papa was singing. He was in his bathroom. He was still taking his bath by himself. He was still up and doing until his last clarion call. He will be singing. "Remember me, O Lord. Remember me, O Lord." He was prepared. Death did not come suddenly on Olubajo. Heaven had a communication with him, and he set his house in order before he departed. Pa Olubajo, a gentleman par excellence, a man of few words, and the most quiet man I ever met. If there was a subject called Silence 101 taught in the university, Pa Olubajo would have been the professor who taught it. Very quiet man. A genuine child of God. You couldn't doubt his conviction about Jesus, about salvation, about heaven. No doubt about his conviction there. So loving was Papa that for many months, he used wisdom to prepare us for his final exit. Part of it was what my wife just said now, when he declared that he was ready to go. And he withdrew, you know, gradually, just to make sure that his departure was not too sudden to us. He recognized the relationship he had, particularly with the children. No wonder. In the night in which he will be taken home, one of the daughter's eye was opened, and three men in white robe, in white apparel, came into Papa's room, and three of them slept in Papa's room. On the morning of 20th of August, they went for the morning routine, and Papa was gone. He put up a video call to us, and we looked at Papa. He didn't look like somebody was dead. Fresh, so quiet, so peaceful. I said, no wonder. The scripture is very clear. Precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his saints. Adio, Pa Nina Lowo Olubajo, until we meet again at the feet of the Lord Jesus. Shegun Owo Tori, your dear son. Thank you.
Hallelujah. Thank you so much, the daughter and the adopted son. Hallelujah. The Lord will be with you in the name of Jesus. I know this is a very aspect that is very difficult to control. But let's help us to control it, please. I will call on Yinka Odunlami, please, to come forward quickly. Very brief, sir. God bless you, sir. Microphone, please. Microphone, please.
Thank you all for welcoming us this evening. And thank you for Abayo for giving me the opportunity. In fact, it's a surprise to me. I didn't know I would be saying anything. But I think this man was a great man. People do not know how great this man was. I knew him in the 60s because my mom's family is the Olubajos. And There are so many of them at Christmas that you will see. So there were so many of them that you will see at Christmas. And it was quite difficult to know who is who. So, but I thank God that in my lifetime, and while this man was alive, he made an indelible impression on my life. And I'm not just saying that. In fact, I've written what I was going to talk about, but it's a genuine experience. I remember when I first of all started off in life, and we were hustling in Lagos then. This gentleman, when I got my first job, it was a temporary job. In fact, I paraphrased it when I wrote it down. But he will always ask my mom, where is Gbenga now? That's what they call me. People don't call me that now. Where is Gbenga now? What's he doing? And, all these things. And then as soon as he got to know where I got the job, he said, we know somebody there. And from there, he established a connection for me. And this was the connection that I enjoyed throughout my stay. From temporary job, I got permanent, and I had my head of department then was like a father to me. In fact, because of the kindness. This is it. You see, if he wasn't kind, he wouldn't give that advice. And as soon as part of the blessing of that job was that they gave us car loan in Nigeria in those days. I know the younger people in Nigeria will be thinking, what's car loan? But they did. And the car I was meant to buy, with that money was so small. But because of this gentleman, he told my mom, there is somebody in their area that is a big man in SCOA Motors. And then they linked me. And the car I got was the car that executives were driving then. And that was, that's the sort of man he is. He's never tired of helping people. And that's what I remembered about him. By the time I was there, his impact. You see, the reason why I'm saying it is that he could have just not done it, but he chose to do it. And any time he saw me, I knew I had, and I mean it, a friend, somebody who genuinely loves me. And, one of the things I said, when we were starting off in life, we used to be, feel we were guys, and then people will report us to our mom that since Gbenga started, he's never bought us drink. He wasn't interested in that, and that didn't stop him from showing very great love. When I was having my engagement, he was always there. But. I'll round up by saying this. One of my older cousins were talking, because I'd known this man for 40 years. And you wouldn't believe that I never saw him argue with anybody. It is unbelievable. He never argued. Whereas people will fight, people will argue, people will hold grudges, but this man never argued with anybody, let alone pick up a quarrel. This is the sort of man. And my main experience was before I came to England in the 80s. So you can imagine. So anytime I got back to Nigeria now, he's just occasionally seeing him. But he hasn't changed. In fact, he's a lot better, because of his, Christian values now. And I'm really grateful to God that this man showed us an example, and I pray that, God will give us the grace so that by the time it's our own, by how do they say it? When it's our own time, people will be able to say nice things about us. I'm really, you see, when I look at a man like this, I saw a reflection of somebody I want to be. I want to emulate all the good values this man has. And I'm not just saying it. You know, when I look at somebody like that, it's unbelievable. But I'll end there. Thank you very much.
Hallelujah.
Thank you for that. I will call on Brother Ayor Olubajo. Please help us make it very short, sir. God bless, sir. Microphone, please. Microphone, please.
I want to thank everybody for attending this ceremony. We so much appreciate it. And on behalf of the Olubajo family, right from Odokpotu in Ijebu, I'm saying thank you very much. We appreciate your presence and the love that you have for coming to this ceremony. Well, we are talking about Brother Babatunde Abiodun Olubajo, because he's a brother to me. And that's how we call them. But if it were in England here, well, people will say, I should be calling him cousin or whatever they call themselves. But in Africa, he's a brother to me. We are from the same family, Olubajo family. His daddy is an elder brother of my own daddy. And we all live in this same enclosure in Odokpotu. Odokpotu is our village in Nigeria. It's just some few distance from Ijebu. It's a small place. It's just like Bethlehem. But it's very, very important. Very, very important. When I say it's very important, I'm not trying to upgrade ourselves. We appreciate ourselves there, and people who know us, they appreciate us. I'm sorry, I'm not going to take your time, because this is not a time to mourn. We are not here to mourn his death. We are here to celebrate his death. He didn't die young. He died over 80 years of age. All the people who have been talking about him have been saying the correct thing, especially our in-law. Whatever he has said is just perfect. He's not trying to you know, impress you. Whatever he has said is the correct thing about our brother. He's a very gentle man, and in fact, almost gentle to a fault. You scarcely see him argue with anybody, at least since the time, you know, we've been together. And he's a very straightforward man, a very loving father. Whatever Abayo said about his daddy is very, very correct. Whatever Yinka Benga Odunlami said about him is also correct. So I appreciate all of you. You may not know him, but at least believe what we talk about him. And take it that is the correct thing we are saying about him. He's a very, like I said, very gentle man, very humble, very friendly. There has never been a time you see him argue with anybody. There has never been a time you see him, you know, being antagonistic to anybody. Because most of the time we meet in that Odokpotu village every year during the Christmas. In fact, you can never miss it. You can never. Because if you don't have the opportunity to go and celebrate Christmas in that village, definitely you will never enjoy that Christmas for that year. Because, you know, you will miss a lot of things. That is when all the family come together. And we have a celebration that we arrange there every year that you will never want to miss it. Even up to our children. Bring them, take them to Christmas in Odokpotu for the first time. They will continue to worry you every year. So we've come here to celebrate his life. It's just a pity that Abayo had to do some crying. Yes, you have to. But because I know the relationship of you and your daddy, especially when you are very, very young. So, but let us put our mind to God, like what it was read in the first lesson. Jesus said, I've gone to prepare a place for you. And he promised that after he has done the preparation, he will come back and take us there. But one thing I want you to understand for all of us who are still living is that what Jesus said is not an automatic promise. You have to work for it. For him to come back and take you there, you have to work for it when you are still here. We're having a lot of problems in the world now. Why? Because we don't have respect for our God. We don't even trust him that he can do anything for us. We think everything that is happening in the world is from our, you know, technology, our knowledge, or anything. Forgetting that he is the owner of this universe. And that if we believe in him, if we trust in him, if we put our confidence in him. What is COVID-19? Unfortunately, none of the scientists have been able to identify it. And what you can't identify, you can never cure. It is when you identify something that you will find the root of that problem. But let's call on God now. If we sincerely call on God as we are here, with all our mind, with faithfulness and belief, before we go out there, COVID-19 will run away. It will run away, and it will never come back. So I appeal to every one of us here that let's put our trust in our God. Our brother has gone. He has forgotten everything. Because a better place has been prepared for him. But for us, all of us who are still living here, don't let us forget our Maker. Because he is a very loving God and is ready to give us anything we require of him. But we have to do his will. And that is why he told us that he is a jealous God. He's a very jealous God. But if we do his biddings, if we obey him, if we walk according to his directions, he's ready to give us that peace, that happiness that we need in this world before we go back to him. So once again, I want to thank every one of you who has been able to come here this evening. I thank God that he brought all of us here peacefully. And I pray that as we are all going back, we will go back to our different places in peace. And we will meet our families at home in good health, in peace, and in serenity. Thank you once again, and I wish you all a safe journey back home.
Hallelujah. Thank you so much, sir. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Let's put our hand together for Jesus. We'll be going to anthem number 9. because of our time, please, we schedule the program to finish 7 o'clock, and it's 7:17 now. Praise the Lord. Please forgive us. We will make it very, very quick. In fact, Daddy, thank you so much. You have made the job of the preacher very, very easy, honestly. The pastor that will be preaching now, please, if I will love you, can just come and share the grace with us. And we'll be getting ready to go. Thank you so much. We really love that short reminder that Lord Almighty God will honor you, sir, in the mighty name of Jesus. The next item is item 9, hymn 7 and 8, but we will not be able to sing both of them. We'll be singing hymn 7, and when we come to item 12, we'll be singing hymn 10 instead of 9. So we've taken out 2 hymns. Sorry for that, if you love those hymns very well. So I will call on my choir leader to, as we come forward for the next hymn, hallelujah. That's hymn 7.
Sing the wondrous love of Jesus, sing his mercies and his grace. In the mansion bright and blessed, he'll prepare for us a place when we all get to heaven. What a day of rejoicing that will be when we all see Jesus. We will sing and shout the victory. While we walk the binding pathway, clouds will overspread the sky. But when traveling day, not a shadow, not a sign, when all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing there will be when we all see Jesus. We will sing and shout the victory. Trusting safely every day. Just one glimpse of glory will the toys of life repay. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be when we all.
Hallelujah. Shall I call on our sister Dayo, as you lead us in the third Bible reading, please. God bless you. Microphone, please. Usher, go. Please appreciate my usher. Please appreciate them for me, please. Wonderful, wonderful usher. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hello, thank everyone. My name is Dayo Showumi Ni Olubajo. I'm reading the third Bible reading from Revelation chapter 21 from verse 1 to 7. I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of the heaven, prepared as a bride adored for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. And he that sat upon the throne said, behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, write, for these words are true and faithful. And he said unto me, it is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him the utterance of the fountain of the water of life freely. He that overcome shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. May God bless his words.
Let us appreciate God. Please. God bless. Let's appreciate him. Hallelujah. We're going into the item 11. We're going into the word. Praise the Lord. And we have the privilege in our midst today to have a pastor from Luton, from a Kingdom Builders family, long away from Luton. And it's a privilege, and we thank God for this day, and the Lord bless every one of us in the name of Jesus Christ. I have the pleasure to invite to the podium our humble pastor, by the joy of the Holy Ghost. Let's welcome Pastor Dada as he comes to the podium for the word, please. God bless you, sir. Yes, sir.
Praise the Lord. Father, we thank you. Lord, we give you praise. We appreciate your love. We appreciate your grace. We appreciate that we are all alive tonight to celebrate the life of your Son. We are not here to mourn, but we are here to praise your holy name. For we know, O God, that it has pleased you to call him home. We thank you that we are alive to survive him. Take all the glory in Jesus' name. Tonight I pray that as you speak to us, that your word will make impact in our lives, and that our lives will never remain the same. We give you praise and we give you honor in Jesus' precious name. Amen. Good evening, everyone. I want to appreciate the Lord in the life of each and every one of us that are here tonight. Thank God for my seniors, my ogas, from Bristol, from Highland, and all other men and women of God in the house. I pray that Jehovah God will continue to strengthen each and every one of us in the name of Jesus. And I want to congratulate our brother and our sister, Pastor Shegu and Pastor Abayomi Anoluapo Owotori. It is well with you in the name of Jesus. God will see you through in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. You know, the life of every one of us seated here today, our life is actually compartmentalized into three parts. And I'm sure some of us will be asking me, what do you mean? Our lives is in three parts. The day that God released us into this world. The second part is the time that we lived. Or the third one is the day that we will exit this world. But do you know that as important as these periods are in our life, the most important one is the middle one, which is our existence here on earth. And so today, in the brief time that I have, I will be asking us a question. A question that you are the one that will be able to answer it for yourself. As much as I love my wife, I cannot answer it for her. As much as you love your spouse, you cannot answer it. You have to answer for yourself, and your spouse will have to answer for herself. And what is the question? How will you be remembered? How would I be remembered when it's time for me to exit this world? You know, James chapter 4, verse 14. James chapter 4, verse 14 says, "Whereas ye know not what shall be on the morrow, for what is your life?" Is a question. It says, "For what is your life?" And straight away, an answer is provided there. It says, "It is even a vapor that appeareth for a little time and then vanisheth away." And so when we talk about our life is like a vapor. It comes and before you know it, it's dispelled into the air and nothing will be seen again. Solomon saying in Ecclesiastes chapter 3 from verse 1 to 2 makes us to understand that to everything there is a season and a time for every matter or purpose under heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck up what is planted. And so it is inevitable, whether we like it or not, as long as God has brought us into this world, a time will come that he will recall us home. And you know, her sister was saying that that was the day she dreaded most. And part of the testimonies that have been said about Papa is that he prepared for his exit. How prepared are you, my brothers, my fathers in the house, and my mothers in the house? How prepared are you, my sister? A day will come that we will close our eyes, never to open it again. But when that day comes, how will you be remembered? What will your legacy be? Many a times we measure the, you know, our lives in terms of time by using seconds, minutes, hours, days, months, and years. And you know what? We hate to go outside of that measurement of time. Our question has always been, how long did he live? We know when we ask how long or how old was Baba, we'll say, oh, he's 86 years old. That is never God's question. God is not interested in your chronological age. On the day of reckoning, he will not ask you and I how old we are. And you will not get a medal for how long you have lived. And have you noticed in the Bible that we have examples of people that lived for years? A good example is Methuselah. Methuselah lived the longest in the Bible. But guess what? His name was only mentioned once. What legacy did he leave behind? Nothing can be said of him. Despite the fact that he lived 969 years, the only thing he succeeded doing is living long, chronologically. I pray for you and I pray for myself that God will give us grace to make our life meaningful while we are still in existence. Paul the Apostle writing to believers like you and I that have crossed from darkness to light in Hebrews chapter 9, the 27th verse says, "And as it is appointed unto men once to die, but after this is what? The judgment." What would your own judgment be? When you appear before the Lord, I hope you know that God has reasons why he has kept you and I to this very time. Are you fulfilling that purpose? Am I fulfilling that purpose? We will all be judged, not by how long chronologically that we have lived, but we'll be judged according to the assignment that God has given us. I like the way that same scripture that I read to you earlier on puts it in the Passion translation, James chapter 4, the Passion. Listen to what he says. He says, "But you don't have a clue what tomorrow may bring. For your fleeting life," in other words, our life is like fleet. "Your fleeting life is but a warm breath of air that is visible in the cold, only for a moment, and then vanishes. Instead, you should say, our tomorrows are in the Lord's hands. And if he's willing, we will live life to its fullest and do this or that." My brothers and my sisters, it is time for us to be mindful of the way we live our lives. We will not be here forever. A time will come that you and I will close our eyes and will not be able to open it. And when that time comes, what will be said of you? What will be said of me? May the Lord bless you in Jesus' name.
Do more than that. God bless you. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Pastor. You actually spent half of your allocated time. Thank you, Pastor Dada. You are wonderful, sir. Thank you so much. We really appreciate you. Thank you. Thank you. The Lord bless you in Jesus' name. I want us to spend just 1 minute to pray for Pastor. Please, let's stretch our hand to him. Let's pray for him. Please, let's just commit him to the hand of God. I always say the message we hear at this very time is not for the deceased. It's not the one that has died. It's for every one of us. Let's just pray for him. Let's commit the church in Luton. Let's commit mommy to the hand of God, the children, biological children, the spiritual children, and the churches under him. Let's commit it to the hand of God. The Lord Almighty God, you will strengthen your son. In the mighty name of Jesus, it will finish well, it will finish strong. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord Jehovah. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Praise the Lord. Once again, thank you, Pastor. God bless you, sir. We are so much grateful. I say it again. The message is for us. It's not for the diseased. It's not for the dead. And we are blessed in Jesus' name. Now, we are going to item 13, prayer for the family. And the prayer for the family is going to be in two sections. Hallelujah. There's going to be prayer, a specific prayer for the daughter in the UK and the adopted son. Hallelujah. That's what Pastor said. He said he has been the adopted son. So I requested a special prayer for the family in the UK. And I will call on Pastor Badibo from Ireland. Please come forward, sir, as the Spirit leads you. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yeah. Good evening, church. Good evening, sir.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Shall we pray? In Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus. Our Father, our Lord, our King, and our Maker. The one who was, the one who is, and the one who is to come. The one whose name is yea and amen. The only one that knew the end from the beginning. The author and the finisher of our faith. Father, we thank you for the legacy that Baba left behind, which part we are looking right in front of us here. We thank you as we have added your word that we are remembering him and we are remembering the seed that he left behind. Father, we bless your holy name. And we thank you for the great thing he left behind for them. Because your word said, once I was young, now I am old. I have never seen the righteous forsaken, nor a seed begging for bread. We thank you, Father, for the legacy of righteousness that Baba Olubajo left behind for his daughter, for his son and his daughter. Lord, accept these thanks in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, my Lord and my God, that you allow them to be here while he had left, because you have not allowed them to be buried before him. Thank you, Father, for that you are given unto us. Lord, accept these thanks in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we bring them before you this day, my Lord and my God, and we are committing them into your hands. Again, I said the word says that once I was young, now I'm old. I have never seen the righteous forsaken or a seed begging for bread. These are the seed of a righteous man. The way you dealt with David for the sake of righteousness of Jesse. Lord God Almighty, you said in your word, the book of 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 16, that the Lord have mercy upon the house of one man called Onesiphorus. Father, I pray that the house of the world to reach is becoming the house of mercy in the mighty name of Jesus. For the righteous way that Baba lived while he was here, may heaven remember you for that and always have mercy on you in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray this day that everything that you desire from God, may heaven give unto you in the mighty name of Jesus. It was said here earlier on that Baba will not create fear around you. I pray that if you are to fear anything, it shall be reverential fear of the Lord in the mighty name of Jesus. No vacuum shall be around you or in your life because of the demise of Baba in the mighty name of Jesus. God in heaven, the Father of fatherless, will be for you all the time in the mighty name of Jesus. Sister Yomi, I pray for you in particular that when you want to pick your phone to say, let me call Baba, or when you want to say, let me wake up and talk to him, I pray this day that you will remember God and heaven and you will not feel any pain in the mighty name of Jesus. If there be anything he does for you while he was here, I pray that heaven will do multiple of that for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Are there things you are proposing your life to achieve while Baba is here? I pray that God Almighty will ensure that you go to the fullest of achievement in the mighty name of Jesus. God shall keep you going. He shall keep you coming. He shall watch over you. The house of Owotori is becoming the house of Obedidom. That God in heaven will locate your house for blessing in the mighty name of Jesus. The word of God says, mark that perfect man. Behold that man that is upright in his heart. He said, his end is peace. I decree that over you and over your house, it shall always be peaceful in the mighty name of Jesus. Heaven said, he shielded, he surrounded Jerusalem with mountains and rock, and he disallowed the rod of the wicked, resting upon the lot of the righteous. I pray this is your lot, because God will shield you, and the rod of the wicked will not rest upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. It shall not rest upon your lot in the mighty name of Jesus. As you are living your life, it shall be life and days of joy in the mighty name of Jesus. God, I bring you and your husband together as brother and sister, as friends. I pray that God will perfect this in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Your home shall be home of joy. It shall be home of rejoicing. It shall be home of celebration. In the mighty name of Jesus, the word of God says, say ye to Rachel that it is well. It is well with you always. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Thank our Lord and our Savior, because we have prayed in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise ye the Lord.
Let's put our hand together. Thank you, sir. Yes, sir. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. As the prayer has been said, so shall it be in the mighty name of Jesus. The second aspect of the prayer is prayer for the extended family. Everyone that is connected to Baba, Babatunde Abiodun Olubajo, both home and abroad, there's a session of prayer for everybody. Praise the Lord. And for also our sister in Nigeria as well, we want to pray along with her. She was the one that was with Daddy when Daddy passed to glory. I really commend her. It is well with her in the mighty name of Jesus. I will call on our senior pastor, Pastor Yemila Dikpo, as he lead us in this session of prayer, like the Spirit direct, please. God bless you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Shall we pray? Our Father, we say thank you. Jehovah, we bless your wonderful name. We give you glory. We give you honor. We adore you, Lord. You are God, and there is none like unto you. You sit in heaven, my Father. You make the earth your footstool. Glory be to your name forever. In the name of Jesus. I want to thank you, Father, in everything your word says we should give thanks. Thank you, Father, for the life of our Father, the one that you have called to your side. We love him, my Father, but you love him more than us. We are grateful, Father, Lord, even for his life. Your son told us the three stages of life. The one, my Father and my God, the one that is spent here on earth. We are grateful, Father, Lord God Almighty, for the period, how we are able to remember him. We're thanking you, Father, Lord God Almighty, everlasting God, for all that have come in contact with him, my Father, when he was here on earth. Thank you, Father, for the immediate family. Thank you, Father, Lord God Almighty, for the extended family. Thank you, Father, for friends. Thank you for acquaintances. Lord in heaven, that you accept our thanks in Jesus' name. We're praying, Father, Lord God Almighty, for all these ones, my Father. Jehovah in heaven, I am asking Almighty Father, that Lord God Almighty, you will look after each and every one in Jesus' name. Unto your hand, Most High God, we commit this family, my Father. We pray, O Lord, how they will navigate, Father, from now on, my God. I ask, O Lord God Almighty, that, Lord, you will lead them, O Lord. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus, pray, Father, for unity. That I am asking, eternal rock of ages. Tribute have been said. His lives have been shown to us. One way or the other, a peace-loving Father. Lord, we pray, my God and my God, that that peace will continue in the family in the mighty name of Jesus. That that unity will continue, O Lord, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. You will bind this family together with a cord of love that can never be broken in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. When he was here on earth, my Father, Daddy, Lord God Almighty, there was no record, O Lord, of any disturbance within the family at his demise, Almighty God. Daddy, I'm asking, O Lord God Almighty, that there will be no disturbance in Jesus' name. Everyone, Father, every plan, Father, how they will do it, how they will plan it, my Father. Daddy, let there be, oh Lord, a peaceful agreement in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Daddy, they have become, oh Lord God Almighty, fatherless, oh Lord, by you taking him, oh Lord, to your side. And you, the Father of the fatherless, we ask, oh Lord, that at every point, Father, Lord God Almighty, when they will miss their father, when they will have a need of their father, you, the Father of the fatherless, please, Lord, in heaven, Daddy, I ask, oh Lord, that, Lord, you will be their father in the name of Jesus Christ. Supernatural wisdom, I ask for each and every one of them in the name of Jesus Christ. And I pray, eternal rock of ages, by your mercy and your mercy alone, oh Lord, that these children, my Father, these family members, oh Lord, they will live beyond the age of Olubajo in the mighty name of Jesus. Not in sickness, oh Lord. Lord, not in affliction, oh Lord. But Father, Lord, the rest, oh Lord God Almighty, of the years of everyone, Daddy, they will live it peacefully in the name of the Lord Jesus. Daddy, we pray for every friend and well-wishers, oh Lord, who have come today, my God and my strength. We ask, eternal rock of ages, that Lord God Almighty, everlasting Father, when it will be our turn, may we see Jesus before death in the name of Jesus. We pray for long life. We pray for good health in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, eternal rock of ages. And as many that have traveled far and near, by the time they will be returning, eternal rock of ages, I pray, Father, Lord, that, Lord, they will get to their destination in peace and in safety in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Abba, Father. We return all the glory back to you. For in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. And the people of God say,
amen. Let's put our hand together for Jesus. Let's appreciate God, please. Let us appreciate God. Hallelujah. Thank you so much, sir. The Lord bless you, sir. I'll be calling on our sister. Yeah, I will call on our sister Shade Olubajo as she leads us in vote of thanks as we're getting ready for the closing of the program. Hallelujah. Let's appreciate God. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Very briefly, ma'am. God bless you, ma'am.
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
Yes. I just want to say thank you to everyone that have come here today on behalf of Olubajo and Owo Tori's family for the celebration of life of our uncle. As I always call him, Baba Bayo, or BABATUNDE. So I thank God for his life and for all of you that have come here today. Father Lord, you will reach your destination safely in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you very much for all coming. Our father, grandfather, brother, uncle, a lovely man. He's one of the only person of mine father siblings that I normally visit when I was in Nigeria every week. If they don't see me, they will look for me. Such a lovely man. Thank you so much. Thank
you. Yeah. Thank you so much, ma. We thank God for that, for making it short for us, ma. The Lord bless you and the Lord we honor you in the name of Jesus Christ. As we call it, service of song. Praise the Lord. We'll be taking we'll be taking him. Where's the choir? Which hymn are we taking now? Last one. Hallelujah. We'll be taking him 11. Okay. You want to override my decision? Okay. Yeah, that's a mistake on the year. Yeah. That is why it's good to have a good choir director. Left to minute, now we just let us go to 11, and so after that we'll be going for benediction and a closing prayer. So 11, M 10, okay.
Last verse.
Lord, by thy stripes which wounded thee, from this day sings thy servants free, that we may live and sing to thee.
Abide with me.
Okay, all.
Abide with me. First falls the eventide. The darkness deepens, Lord, with me abide. When all the helpers fail and comforts flee, Lord, abide with me.
Verse 2.
Swift to his close, ebbs out life's little day. As joy grows dim, glories pass away, change and decay. In all around I see, oh, thou who changest not, abide with.
Verse 3.
I need thy presence every passing hour. What but thy grace can foil us and pass by.
Verse 4.
I fear no foe, with thee art unto bless.
Shall we be seated, please? Let's be seated. Praise the Lord. Please, as we announced earlier on, please let us do things orderly. Don't let us do it as if we are breaking the law. Praise the Lord. With the management of the church, that is how we think we can do it. That will be orderly, and we will follow the guidance. Please and please, don't form bubble of more than six at any time, either inside or outside. Please let us remain on our seat as the celebrant, or so to say, goes around, say thank you to every one of us, praise the Lord. And after that, let us file out. The minister will be there to guide us. Let us file out when the time is for us to go out. Let us go out line by line. Please, that is how we think we can do it. If it's not really how you want it, please just bear with us. When we go to Tesco's and they ask us to line up, we don't argue with them. Praise the Lord. Please, the Lord Almighty God will bless us in the name of Jesus. Once again, we want to say thank you, Pastor and Pastor Mrs. Stella. Thank you so much. We really appreciate your coming. Pastor Gbadebo, thank you so much. Our greetings to Mommy back in Ireland. God bless you, sir. Our daddy from Bristol, thank you so much. We appreciate you and the minister that come with him. All our ministers from Luton, thank you so much. The Lord bless you in the name of Jesus. Pastor and pastors, Pastor Mrs. Oyada from Overcomers House, Gloucester in Paris, thank you so much. We appreciate it. And all the ministers of God, our elders, our daddies and mommy that could not be able to mention your name, thank you so much. Overcomers House Choir, you are amazing. Let's appreciate them, please. Let's appreciate them. My photographer, should I call you paparazzi or what? God bless you. You're wonderful. You're wonderful, son. God bless you. And everyone of Overcomers House Gloucester, you are wonderful. Yes, sir. Hallelujah. God bless you, sir. We really appreciate you. Let's appreciate him, please. He came away right from Birmingham. He came from Birmingham. Hallelujah. God bless you in the name of Jesus. Do I have a Birmingham accent? Do I have a Birmingham accent? Okay, thank you. He came from Birmingham. God bless you in the name of Jesus. We appreciate everybody. Everybody from London, from all over the UK, and all our people from all over the works of the world, in Nigeria, in America, everywhere you are watching us, the Lord bless you in the name of Jesus. All the Papa's family, the Lord will be with you in the mighty name of Jesus. Revelation chapter 21, verse 4. And God shall wipe away all tears from thy eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away, in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Overcomers House ministers, thank you so much. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. You are blessed in the name of Jesus. We'll be taking benediction and vote of thanks. Closing prayer. I will call on Pastor Yemila Dipo from Bristol, our zonal pastor, to just finish with us, and as we're getting ready to go, the Lord bless you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Father, Lord God Almighty, for bringing us here, Almighty God, to celebrate, Father Lord, the life of Pa Olubajo. We thank you, Eternal Rock of Ages. Daddy, as we are about to depart to our various destinations, Lord, I ask Almighty Father, the Lord God Almighty, you will take each and everyone back to their home in peace and in safety, in the mighty name of Jesus. And my God and my Father, on your behalf, I bless these your children. The Lord bless and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you
The Lord be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace, even from this time forth and forevermore. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name. And the people of God say, shall we share the grace together? May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of God forever and ever. Amen.
Hallelujah. Let's put our hand together for Jesus, please. On the pulpit, I think I made a mistake. Our family friend, I sat at the back. They are not from Luton. They are actually from Meeting King. Hallelujah. Pastor and Pastor Mrs. Adiel. God bless you, ma. God bless you, sir, in the name of Jesus Christ. They are from Meeting King, not from Luton. You are blessed in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Let's be seated. God bless you. Let's have our seat. Hallelujah.
Thank you. Hallelujah, Oluwa lati da mi lare, 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 Oluwa lati